Hey, what's up guys, it's Mac and we're back with another tech review video, and today we're going to compare the Wacom Intuos Draw with Huion 640p. Of course, we're going to check what do we get in each package, check its physical overview, and run through its features. If you're interested, stay tuned and watch the video. So what do we get in the box? In Wacom, the tablet itself, the battery-free pen with 3 Nibs replacement included at the back of the tablet, a detachable USB cable, a CD driver, and some documentations. In Huion's package, of course, the tablet itself, the battery-free pen holder, and inside it, there are 8 more Nibs replacement, a detachable USB cable, a driver link download page that's written that looks like a CD, and a manual. Now, let's check out some physical overviews. First, let's check out the pens. So this is the Wacom's pen. It's a bit smaller than the Huion's pen and more lighter. Huion's pen, on the other hand, is in the heavier side, and I am more into that than the lighter one. Well, that depends on the user preferences, so if you think otherwise, then you buy whichever you prefer. Both are made out of plastic, and both have 2 fully programmable buttons. On the texture side, Huion got a gray metallic design with a rubber grip near the tip of the pen, and Wacom has this matte black finish all over. The Huion's pen got a stand, which is a plus, but Wacom has this cloth type that holds the pen. It's more like Wacom is a ready-to-go type of a tablet, and Huion is more like a stay-at-home tablet. As I've mentioned earlier, there are 8 more Nibs replacement included in Huion's package, but in Wacom's, you'll get 3 Nibs replacement that are located at the back of the tablet itself, which I guess is plenty enough, but if you needed more than 3, you can buy 5 pieces separately for $5. To remove the Huion's pen nibs, you need to use the stand, and underneath you'll see this remover. All you have to do is just to put it in and pull it out. To remove the Wacom's pen nibs, you need to open the back of the tablet itself and use the hole over here to remove it. Now let's check out the tablet's physical overview. Both have almost the same weight and a rubber grip on the back that holds them in place. Wacom has 4 programmable buttons, and Huion got 6 programmable buttons. But in comparison, Wacom has this anti-ghosting feature, and Huion doesn't. Anti-ghosting means when multiple keys are pressed simultaneously, it will still work. So that's a plus for Wacom. However, Huion compensates it with its software function, because you can set a single button with multiple keys pressed in one single button. Also, Huion has this enable and disable switch for the buttons on the tablet. Wacom doesn't, but it is placed wisely above the tablet, which you won't accidentally press them while drawing. On the other hand, Wacom can go wireless, but unfortunately for Huion, it doesn't have an option like this. However, the wireless module, receiver, and rechargeable battery are not included in the package, which you have to pay another $40 more to get these accessories. And that's a bit of a downer in my opinion. But if you got $40 more to spend, then these options are available for you. Now let's check out some specification. So this is the active area for Huion, and this is the active area for Wacom. Intuos Draw has 1024 pressure sensitivity, and Huion has 8192 levels of pressure sensitivity, and you'll feel the difference of this if you try using both. And if you want to know more of the specification of each, you can just pause the video and check these specifications. On the software side, Wacom dominates it all. Wacom has this link to a software feature, wherein if you are using both Blender and Photoshop at the same time, the button configuration set for those specific software changes whenever you change the active window. And of course, Huion doesn't have this kind of feature. Also, Wacom has this cloud storage for your personal setting for each software use for the tablet configuration, wherein you will be able to log in using Facebook, Twitter, Google, or your own personal email address. And of course, Huion doesn't have this feature. Yes, Huion can program these buttons, but you have to manually save them and switch profile from time to time if ever you'll be switching from software to software. And that's really a big of a downer if you'll ask me. Well, if you're not using many softwares while editing, this will not be an issue for you, but for me, it is. Now let's move on to do some Blender painting. First, let me describe the feel of the drawing while using these tablets. Huion got this smooth feel while drawing and you don't actually hear anything while using it. Compared to Wacom, it's like you're drawing into a real paper and you'll constantly hear the paper and pen collision sound like. Other than that, you'll definitely feel the difference of the pressure sensitivity. After using the H640P for a long time, going into Intuos Draw that has only 1024 pressure sensitivity, it feels like there is something lacking. It's like the lines are jumping instead of going smoothly. I'm not sure how to describe this, but you'll get what I mean if you try using both of these tablets. On the other hand, I like the implementations of the buttons of the Wacom because of its anti-ghosting feature. Not that I constantly use these buttons, but this is something that you'll want if you want to draw in a relaxed position. So in conclusion, I made this comparison for you. Just pause the video, check the difference before deciding what to buy. So that's it guys, if you found this video interesting and helpful, make sure you give us a thumbs up and share it. If you want some more, simply subscribe as well as follow our socials down in the link in the description below. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next episode.